Mr. Speaker.
I call Todd McLean.
Mr. Speaker, that was an appalling speech from that last member, full of doom and gloom, and that was it. Anybody would think we were back to the dark old days of the Labor government. I was about to pick up the telephone and ring my doctor and say to the doctor, if I listen to David Clark speak for 10 minutes, will I live longer? And his answer would have been no, but it surely would seem like it. An appalling speech. Because, Mr. Speaker, this piece of legislation is about a government that's building a more competitive and productive economy for New Zealanders. It's about lifting economic performance. It's about creating 70,000 jobs so far, many more to come, and boosting incomes for improving living standards for people from the very north of the North Island to the south of the South Island. Great stuff from a good minister and a good government, and no wonder that was an appalling speech from the last man on his feet, David Clark, because there's nothing that they can add that would do any more or any better than what our minister is delivering for us today. What will this bill do, Mr. Speaker, in brief? Simplifies tax filing requirements for individuals and supports businesses and the way they handle their taxes, something the Labor Party in government for 9 years could have done, but no, apparently they think that's tinkering. Weren't interested in it then. It brings in measures to ensure that expenditure on software development is now deductible. Could have done it under 9 years of a Labor government. No, wasn't then. Couldn't be bothered with it back then, and today they say it's tinkering. The bill also changes the thin capitalisation rules for foreign-owned banks. I bet you that hasn't just arrived now or happened just now, Mr. Speaker. Bet you this was an issue over 9 years of a Labor government. Did they do anything about it then? No. And today they call it tinkering. The effects of these rules is to limit foreign-owned banks' interest deductions against the New Zealand tax base. That's good for our New Zealand taxpayers because it makes the taxes paid broader and more people sharing in this as they should be. Two measures announced in Budget 2011, increasing the KiwiSaver minimum contributions for employers and employees and increasing the minimum equity holding for foreign-owned banks. Now, I want to, for a moment, speak about KiwiSaver, a very important policy that a lot of New Zealanders are involved in and enjoy. And I bet you they're glad, as a national government, we've done a lot to reinforce, strengthen and future-protect KiwiSaver for all New Zealanders who are involved. And the government's committed to lifting the national savings rates to reduce New Zealanders' long-standing debt to overseas lenders and deepen our capital markets so that businesses can access funds they need to grow. Not something that happened under a Labor government over 9 years, Mr. Speaker. In fact, one needs only do what the Labor opposition likes to do, ask the Parliamentary Library for some research, come to this House to quote it and table it, and they'll see that New Zealanders borrowed more and became more indebted than almost any other time that I can remember or research in the 9 years that Labor were in government. So KiwiSaver, very important, 1.9 million New Zealanders involved in KiwiSaver, about 17,500 new members a month for each month over the last 12 years under a national government. KiwiSaver funds have grown from $9 billion to $12 billion in the past year. KiwiSaver funds are estimated to be worth $60 billion by 2025. That's our commitment to this, Mr. Speaker. This isn't tinkering as the last government, the Labor opposition, would have us say. These are good, hardcore facts, commitment on behalf of the national government to New Zealanders. Final point I want to raise is around an SOP to be brought, it's been brought before us to benefit quake victims who are still facing real and ongoing difficulties. 18 months since the tragic and devastating events on the 22nd of February, the earthquake in Christchurch, and this SOP is another way the government is supporting the people of Christchurch by providing all the practical help that we can. This is not tinkering, this is a robust piece of legislation. It's a very big piece of legislation. I'm glad that the Labor opposition have said that they will support it. It surprises me because anything of worth this government does, they're actually not on side with. They want New Zealanders to think that things are much worse than they are. Good piece of legislation. Look forward to them joining us finally on doing something that's good for New Zealanders. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
The Honourable David Parker.
Mr. Speaker, we heard from the last speaker that New Zealand